This is video 2 for chapter 8, Metamorphic Rocks and Metamorphism. We're going to start discussing texture. By definition, the texture is the size, shape, and arrangement of the mineral grains present in the rock. With metamorphic textures, there is a certain texture called a foliation or a foliated metamorphic texture where there is a preferred orientation of mineral grains. The minerals that have preferred orientation tend to be elongate in nature or platy in nature, like a mica. This is an example of an elongate mineral. Amphibole would be an example. A platy mineral are the micas. Other examples of foliation besides the platy or elongated minerals, you can have parallel alignment of flattened pebbles or grains. You can get actual banding of dark and light minerals. And cleavage that is present can also be split into slabs, and that is an example of what we call slaty cleavage or rock cleavage, and is a type of foliation. An example. Let's take this igneous rock, whatever it may be, a granite or a diorite. The grains, the minerals that make up the igneous rock are randomly oriented. Then we apply a differential stress on the left and right sides compared to a smaller stress on top and bottom, and the minerals will align themselves perpendicular to the primary stress direction, and you get a banding. This is a type of foliation. So foliation can be done or accomplished by rotation of the platy minerals, actual recrystallization, forming new minerals perpendicular to the maximum stress direction, and flattening of rounded grains. For an example of flattening of rounded grains, here we have a quartz grain. And we can say this is a quartz sandstone, or just quartz grains and there's water in between. What can happen with differential stress as you get an actual slipping along the crystal structure? And so you get the grains elongating perpendicular to maximum stress direction, in this case top and bottom. So you get an elongation perpendicular to the stress direction. In another example of a spherical quartz grain, here we have the actual mineral matter moving from the high stress area up here on top and recrystallizing to the lower stress areas on the right and left sides. That will also create an elongation in that rounded grain. I want to introduce some foliated textures now. First, we have rock or slaty cleavage. This is where the rocks split into thin slabs, as you can see here in this picture on the bottom. This is a slate, so slate is the name of the metamorphic rock with this type of foliated texture, and the parent is a shale. Shale is a detrital sedimentary rock. And when it is subjected to low-grade metamorphism, it turns into a slate. Slate can be used as roofing material. It also creates issues in construction because of the thin slabs that break. The next texture I want to introduce is schistosity. With the rock cleavage, the mineral grains in the slate are too small to be seen. Once we get to the texture referred to as schistosity, the platy minerals, the micas, can be seen with the unaided eye. Rocks having schistosity texture are simply called a schist. One last thing with schists is that this is an intermediate to high-grade metamorphic rock. Our next foliated texture is gneissic texture, which was shown in a previous slide. Gneissic textures indicate high-grade metamorphism, where ions are actually moving and segregating into light and dark bands. We call these metamorphic rocks gneiss. Now, gneisses do not split as easily as slates and schists. Here we have the parent to the gneiss, where the parent is an igneous rock with randomly oriented minerals. The ions then migrate into light and dark bands under high-grade metamorphism due to differential stress, and this is what the gneiss looks like. So gneisses have gneissic textures. Other metamorphic textures besides foliated are non-foliated. These metamorphic rocks are made up of minerals that are equidimensional in shape, meaning the X, Y, and Z axes are the same. Where does this occur? In environments where deformation is minimal and the parent rock has equidimensional grains like quartz or calcite. Another texture that's quite interesting is the porphyroblastic texture, where you get unusually large grains, such as garnets, we call porphyroblasts, surrounded by a fine grain matrix, usually of a mica of some sort. Here's an example of a porphyroblast, and this is the ground mass, which is made up of mica. I can see the mica, so I would call it at least a schist grade, and I would name the rock a garnet mica schist. Let's give names to our foliated rocks first. Slate, very fine-grained mica, resembles a shale. The parent is a shale or a mudstone or a siltstone. Low-grade metamorphism. The degree of metamorphism between a slate and a schist is called a phyllite. And a phyllite can be distinguished from a slate by its foliation being wavy instead of flat. We still have the mica, platy minerals, and you still cannot see the grains without magnification. They are a little bit larger than in a slate, and so you get a shiny appearance to a phyllite when compared to a slate. So technically both slate and phyllite exhibit rock cleavage. I actually like to use the term phyllitic texture for the phyllites. When you have a schist, you are now up to the intermediate to high grade metamorphic conditions, and so the grains have grown to be medium to coarse in size. You can see them without magnification. Platy minerals dominate, so you get nice sparkly micas, and oftentimes the porphyroblasts exist. Garnets are very common porphyroblasts and schists. The highest grade foliated rock is the gneiss. It is medium to coarse grained. It has the banding appearance. I call it the zebra rock. So you have feldspar rich layers and then ferromagnesian rich layers. Here's a summary table showing our slate, phyllite, schist, and gneiss. These are our foliated rocks. Notice a picture of the texture, which is quite handy. We go from fine-grained, flat layers to fine-grained, wavy in the phyllite to coarse-grained in the schist to actual banding in the gneiss. Also listed in this table are common parents or protoliths to these metamorphic rocks. We're going to look at the marble, quartzite, and hornfels, which are non-foliated metamorphic rocks next. A marble is a metamorphosed limestone or dolostone. It will fizz with hydrochloric acid because its mineral is calcite. Marble is a fairly soft rock, and is used as decorative and monument stones. Very susceptible to dissolution in rainwater, that chemical weathering process we talked about in Chapter 6. Next non-foliated rock is quartzite. Quartzite forms from the metamorphism of a quartz sandstone. The quartz grains in a quartzite are no longer individual, they are fused together. And hornfels is a non-foliated rock that is baked by intruding magma. It is fine-grained, dull luster, and the parent rocks are usually a shale or mud-rich rocks. Here we have a quartz sandstone, a detrital sedimentary rock. We are going to metamorphose it into a quartzite. Notice in this close-up, you have individual sand grains in the quartz sandstone that are cemented together. Then, when it becomes metamorphosed, you don't have those individual grains anymore. They are fused together. I'm going to stop video 2 at this point and talk about metamorphic environments in video 3.